Lanny, a North Carolina woman who made national headlines after a tragedy, is looking to move on with her life. Rachelle Friedman became known as the Paralyzed Bride after an accident at her bachelorette party left her seriously injured. But now she's married and she's looking forward. And today she reached an amazing milestone. Rob Wu spoke with Friedman as she got behind the wheel for the very first time, and he joins us live with the story.
Yeah, Kim and Wanda, it's been about 21 months since that freak accident left Rachelle Friedman paralyzed. And since then, a lot's changed. As you said, she married her college sweetheart about 3 months ago. She also got a tattoo, which we'll talk about later. And today, she's learning how to drive all over again.
The journey back to normalcy for Rachelle Friedman has not been easy. Her determination and spirit during the rehabilitation process has been remarkable, her mother says. And today, another huge step.
I've been hurt now for, it'll be 2 years in May, that I haven't driven, that I haven't been independent. So this is huge. I mean, you think about driving from the time that you're hurt, you know, through all through rehab, it's like a big milestone.
Which is why Friedman finds herself in Guilford County today, hoping to take the wheel for the first time since her accident. But first, a battery of tests to determine if she's ready.
How much strength you have in your arms and your wrist and your hands to be able to control the car and your sitting balance. Different things that the average person wouldn't think about.
90 minutes later, it's time for Friedman to get on a different set of wheels, and she's understandably excited and nervous.
I used to drive with my feet, my legs, you know, so I have to kind of rethink everything and learn that it's my hands that are going to be pushing the gas. You know, it's all hand controls and it's new. So this is the first time for me.
After getting situated in the van, her drive for independence is put up to the test. A couple circles around the parking lot later.
You did good. You did great.
It's time for her to hit the road. And Rachel is already looking forward to the day she gets her license back.
Getting my license again is almost better than getting it when you're a teenager because you expect it then. And, you know, it's kind of a new test, a new milestone. It's bigger for me. It's, you know, it's independence for my life, not just to go have fun as a teenager.
And regardless of how things shake out, Rachel says she's content. She recently got a tattoo on the back of her neck that reads, "Let It Be." And yes, of course, that comes from the Beatles song, a group of which she is a huge fan of. Ken and Wanda, back to you.
All right. Thanks a lot, Rob.